Hey everyone, welcome to the second video on using the Flipper Zero with the Genie garage door. In the first video, I showed how to capture codes from your remote, and then we looked at a Python script to generate sub-GHz files. In this video, we'll test a bunch of sub-GHz files that we created from our captured remote. We'll start by pairing the Genie receiver to our Flipper Zero, and then we'll send various signals. By the end of the video, you'll understand how to make a set of four files that will always open the door. Watch out though, if your neighbor has a flipper, they'll be able to capture your signal too. In a future video, we'll look at an encoder and decoder, which will enable us to securely open the door. Please follow the steps from the previous video to create sub-GHz files using the keys.txt file that you captured from your remote. Once you've created all the files, copy them to your SD card sub-GHz folder. Let's get started. I have my Genie receiver on the left connected to a motor so you can see when it would open the door. Next, I'll clear all saved remotes, so we simply hold the Learn button on this receiver until the light stops blinking. Now that it's stopped blinking, I'll show the remote again, and here you can see the remote is on, but the motor no longer spins. So we successfully removed the pairings. We'll go ahead and press the pair button on the receiver, and you can see it's now blinking. On our flipper, we'll go to sub-GHz, and then we'll go down to saved, and then Genie 0001. And we'll go ahead and send that signal, and you can see the light is now solid for the pairing. We'll go to 0002 and send that. And the light's now off so that it's paired at this point. We'll go to 0003. And this time you can see it opens the door. The motor turns on. If we increase to 0004, the motor turns on. So we'll go ahead and jump ahead a few. So we're going to go to 10 hex, which is 16 total. And we said that, and that opens. So that gap is okay. And from 10, we're going to go to 1F, and we'll try sending that. And it took a minute, but 1F works as well. So that's a difference of F. We'll go to 20, which is the next code. And that opens, no surprise there. But now we'll go to 30, which is a difference of 16 decimal. And you can see that at 16, it no longer works. So the codes have to be within 15 of each other for them to open. So now we'll go ahead and go back to 24. So we were at 20 successful. And now you can see that even a gap of 4 isn't good enough because we sent a code that didn't work. So in this case, once you send a code that's too far in the future, then your next code has to be within 3 of the last code. So now we'll jump way ahead to 101 hex, which is considered a future code, and we'll send that. And we can see that the receiver blinks a little bit, but it doesn't spin the motor. However, it does know this 101 code. So when we send the next number, 102, it re-increments our counter. And now we're set to 102 as our starting point. 121 is a future code. So we'll go ahead and send that. You can see the receiver blinking, but the motor's not working. And then we'll go to 125, which is a difference of 4. And we'll send that, and it doesn't work. So the future codes, when you're doing this, the gap has to be 3 or less. So let's go ahead and send that 121 again to recalibrate. And that's resetting our future to 121. And now we'll do 124, which is 3 difference, and it opens. So it needs to be within 3 difference when you're doing those future codes. So we'll go ahead and send 200. That's our future. And 201 is our open. There we go. And so now we're going to jump way ahead from 201 all the way up to 4201. So 4,000 hex difference, 16,000 decimal. There's our future. Set this next code, 4002. And that's too much to jump. So that's not working. So let me go to 4200, send that. Remember, we were at 201 before. And now we'll go to 4201. So 4200 and 4201. So exactly 4,000 hex difference for that second digit, and that works. So that means we're able to jump ahead by 4,000 hex, which is just over 16,000 digits. So now we can see that that works at the 8,200. So now we'll do C200. And set that, and C2001 should give us that open again. There we go. And now we can go back to the beginning and play that 200 and 201 signals. And we've successfully looped our remote. Next, we'll use the Python script to create pairs of signals. So we'll put in the code for the 200, and then we'll put in the code for 201. Both of these goes in our numbers, and don't forget the 0x in front of them. We'll go ahead and run that Python Genie, and then we'll copy the output to Genie0200_201. Next, we'll scroll down 4,000 hex values. And we'll grab those two codes, put them in our file, run the Python script, and do the copy. And then we'll repeat the process for 8200, 8201, and C200 and C201. We'll right-click on our files, and we'll say Reveal in File Explorer. Then we'll bring up QFlipper. And then we'll select the four files we created in our file explorer and drag them over into QFlipper. We last transmitted the C201, which means that the 0200201 is the next sequence we need to send. So we'll go ahead and load that 200201 file. And we'll click send. And so now it's sending the 200 codes for a while and then the 201, and you see the motor just turned on. So now we'll go to the 4200, 4201. We'll go ahead and send that, sending the 42, 4201, and the motor turned on. 82, 8201. There we go. And the motor turned on. And C2, C201. This one's taking a little bit. We can see the red light blinking. So needs to just get the sequence in the right order. There we go. And 200201. And now we can go back to our initial file. And we have our four files. So this is a nice solution if you're looking for four files that will open your Genie garage door. However, because you are doing that rotation, your neighbors could capture those files with their flipper and be able to access your door. In a future video, we'll look at how we can use an encoder and decoder so that we only have to send one signal at a time instead of looping around like we're doing now. Please like and subscribe, and if you have any comments, leave them below or my Discord. Thanks a lot.